Tides Up Change Season 2. I'm Gao Ang.
And I'm Kirk Apesland, a Canadian vlogger living here in mainland China.
And we're now in Daishan County, northeastern part of Zhejiang Province. So today is a little bit special about our live streaming.
We're actually in the middle of a typhoon at the only recognized typhoon museum in all of mainland China.
It's one and only museum here in China. And you know how fast the wind is right now?
3.4 meters per second, 3.6 meters per second.
We're holding like a convenient device to test the wind of the typhoon.
Yeah, it tests how fast the wind is going, and
yeah.
It actually tests it shows you the direction of the wind also.
Yeah, it will be more accurate. So usually the typhoon, when it reaches the level 12, it will be 35 meters per second. But as you can see, as it comes down a little bit, it's now like a 0.6. But here right now, we are having a larger one. But before that, we are now joined by Mr. Zhao Hujiu. 你好, 赵局长.
你好.
He's the head of the Weather Bureau here in Daishan County, and also the head of the China Typhoon Museum.
这赵局长，您能给我们介绍一下这个仪器吗？这是怎么测风的？好的，这是一套很环保、高科技的移动气象站。它观测的要素有六个要素：风向、风速、雨量、温度、湿度、气压。
So it's like a mobile weather station. It can test the wind and speed and also the temperature and also how many rains, those all kind of factors about of the weather.
它的主要的功能呢是便于野外观测，尤其是没有外面没有视点，不方便用电的地方，
so let's turn around to see how they like, if you want to go around to take a look. So usually used for outdoors, the detector, and also,
this
is a solar power, as you can see. Here is a solar power panel here. So it can be both, has the electricity from the battery and also from the sun. 那这个还有什么其他的这种功能吗？其他的主要是那个观测功能。观测，那现在主要是在野外是吧？对，我们今天的话正好是台风影响，我们在这里，现气象的同事在这里在实地的来。
观测这个是现在风力还有多少？
So today we happen to be in the Typhoon Chanthu as it hits Zhejiang area, and now we are using it to detect the wind speed. 那么那边有一个显示屏，对吧？能给我们读一读现在这个数是多少吗？ So as you can see, here is a little screen.
现在的气压。
So now the pressure.
现在气压是1002.500帕。
I says over
1,000.
So it's a 4.5 meters per second. And 24 Celsius degree. So we also noticed, Kirk, there was a huge rock there. 赵局长，我们往那边看，有一个这个大的石头啊。能给我们讲讲这个大石头是什么吗？
This rock actually was blown in by a typhoon. That shows you the power of a typhoon. It's actually typhoons have. The power of an atom bomb.
Yeah, it seems like you're doing your research. So, 赵总，您给我们讲一下这个石头。这块石头呢，原来是在下面的海滩上面的沙滩上面。那个04年的时候呢，有一次台风呢，把这个石头呢，海浪上来，风暴潮喷的海浪上来，把石头从沙滩卷上上面。I can't believe that. So it used to brought by a huge typhoon from sea to the land.
所以那个时候是没有那些保护措施的时候，它会这样，对吗？对对对。今年7月23到28号呢，我现在受到今年第六号烟花台风的严重影响，正好这是烟花台风呢碰到了风雨潮三碰头，对我们。 浙江沿海呢造成巨大的损失，在普陀舟山的普陀登陆的。So
there used to no protection, so the typhoon could brought it here, but now because of all the protection there, so there's no rock here. But because of this year's typhoon Yinfa, it also came closer a little bit. And if you want to take a closer here at the rock, 能给我们一个近距离的看一下这个石头啊，这完全是从海里面这个吹到陆地上的。纯天然的礁石。 Yes, a rock from the sea. So now let's get inside a little bit.
And it's heavy.
Yeah,
and this is like this is not a small rock.
Can you believe that Kirk is 2 tons?
2 tons. Well, that's more than I can lift.
Yeah.
烟花台风的这个大浪啊，把它一直从那边卷到了这里。
So the so after it was brought first, the typhoon Yinfa in July brought it closer here. So we can imagine how strong the typhoon is. And now before we're getting in, let's see Kirk, tell us what's the wind speed there?
4.4, 4.85 meters per second, 5.2 meters per second.
Yeah, it's
still pretty windy out here.
Yeah, of course.
And very wet.
Compared to typhoon, it might not be that strong, but still we can feel the wind here. And now let's get inside the Typhoon Museum.
Well, it's 10 o'clock today, and the typhoon, the center of the typhoon, actually hit here yesterday at 12 noon.
Yes. So now we're inside the Typhoon Museum. And if you want to take an overlook of this.
Yeah,
it is wet out there.
Yeah, we are soaked. Yeah. So still, we're very excited since this is one and only Typhoon Museum here in China. And also, Mr. Zhao is the head of the China Typhoon Museum and also head of the Weather Bureau here in Daishan County. And Zhao Juan, 先给我们介绍介绍这个台风博物馆是什么时候建成的？
我们这个中国台风博物馆呢，是全国唯一以台风为主题的气象灾害，一个博物馆，主题博物馆。台风博物馆建成于2003年。
So it was built in 2003.
Yeah.
然后这些是在讲了是什么呀？台风博物馆呢，它这个一期呢，我们是通过展览的方式，向大家呢，让大家走进台风，来认识台风，了解台风，从而呢，对那个对台风的灾害有一个全面的认识，对防台抗灾的意识有个全面的提高。这里展览的展示的主要是台风的结构，台风的一些特性。
Yeah, so also, 您再给我们讲讲这个灿都啊，因为这次我们想知道灿都有什么。So Mr. Zhao just said that the museum is built for us to know more about typhoon, like how it's formed and what's its impact. So I'm asking him to let us know more about Chanthu. We know Chanthu is like a very strong and now is still heading north, but has already brought huge rainstorm and also strong wind for East China's coastal areas. So
赵局长，这个灿都，这次跟其他能简单的用两三句话给我们讲一讲有什么样的区别？好的，今天呢，我们还正受着今年第14号台风菜都的严重影响。这是菜都台风呢，它有几个特点呢？一个呢，它的强度强，它在运动着，现在至今还没登陆，在上海徘徊，它的中心风力有时阵风17级。
So the wind force has already reached 17, which is quite strong, Kirk.
Well, and that's different than in the Western world because we go from, on a hurricane, we go from level 1 to level 5. We don't do the, I think it's
like 17, we're like,
yeah.8级到17级。就是说全部的，如果说这个整个的横级来讲，横级的话，始终维持17级到15级，到现在已经还有14级。它移动速度很快。
The typhoon still has like now it's still 15, but I know it's different in the Western
world,
right?
Well, you know, you've got hurricanes and typhoons are different in the West.
But how are they different?
Well, they're actually not different. They're exactly the same thing, except for they're exactly the same thing. They're like it's just the name. It's just the area of the world that it's in. A typhoon is in the northwest part of the Pacific Ocean, mm-hmm. Northeast and north central, and the North Atlantic. That's hurricane. The rest is typhoon, except for in the Indian Ocean in the South mm-hmm. Pacific. They call it a cyclone.
If you want to talk to the camera, let our audience know. But before getting to that,
再一个特点呢，它是运行移动的这个轨迹很诡异，运行速度，所以我们现在全球各大台啊。 对这个它的移动路径的预报了，我们网上这个话叫全体翻车嘛，就是这个。到现在为止，它在上海闵行区的外面以东外面的海面上回旋扫动，还没离开。
So Mr. Zhao said typhoon is also typhoon Chanthu is also different from other different typhoons because it has a very strange route. So it moves very fast and now still lingers in 在杭州湾对吧？现在在上海，在上海外面，外海上，外面的海上，移动的海面。那我们也可以看到后面有很多很多的仪器，赵局长给我们介绍一下，就是说这些是什么时候开始用来测台风的，然后是怎么测的？好的，这里呢是一个我们叫测风仪的展示区，这里呢有陈列了一些我们收集的一些测风仪，其中这个叫达因风仪，是英国人达因发明的。 So it's invented by a British scientist, Daishan, right?
他是那个在
19th century，这个呢是这样的，这个呢是一个就是测风向，还有呢风速，这个是安装在室外户外的屋顶上面的，下面这个是一个记录仪，这个其实原来有张纸头，这个记录仪在室内的。 通过呢，要跟管子从这里把它接起来。风的话，这个上面它有一个，也是有，你看这里有一个空的一个孔，这里有一个孔，这个孔有一个管子，跟这个孔的管子跟这个其实是连在一起的。So
these two parts are actually connected together.
And it's a pressure tubeometer is what it is.
The
wind comes through and it weighs the temperature, and this is how they figure out how fast the speed
and also the pressure, right? The temperature.
The pressure of the air coming in is weighed by this, and it actually tells you how fast the wind is.
It's the same as these ones over here.
下面里面有液体带动了一个液压机的上下浮，在都是刻度来。这套仪器主要就是瞬时那个接大风速的。So this is used to test the wind speed in a very short moment. Like when we say like typhoon reaches 17th level, the wind force reaches 17th level, it means in a very short moment. So this is can also to detect like how strong it is in a very short time. And also,
这里面有个液体，液体会带动那个液压的上下浮动，带动一个记录器刻度。这里本来有张记录纸的。So
this is a liquid there, so it can help them to test and then to rotate and then test how strong it is.
I knew what it was, but I didn't know how it worked.
Yes, really. Yeah, this is what he said. Like, put it, like, connect two parts together in the. 这个风是通过来这边，对吧？对。So as it pushes here, then it says, 这给我们介绍一下其他的吧，因为我们看到还有很多很多特别有意思的。这个呢叫双压摆测风仪，测风器。So here you can observe that there are two panels, and I think they're of different weight, right?
Well, they'll show you the speed of the speed of the wind. Also, it's just a different type of thermometer.
这里是一个刻度表，这是刻度。轻的压板，它的刻度是观测的范围多少呢？是0毫米到20毫米。
Can you try to guess what he says? Like, because this shows the numbers, right?
Well, yeah, it'll show and it'll gust up to a certain thing and it'll come back to where the wind is.
And this is lighter than this one, right?
Oh yeah, okay. So what's the why?
这个呢，重的这一块，它的刻度算上去是0毫米到40毫米，这个差了一倍。 什么概念呢？So
this is like from 0 to 40 meters per second.
Okay.
我们以风这个风力的这个换算什么概念呢？这块轻板移到上面是最多测到八级风。But
here they can only test the level 8 wind force. 但是这边是多少秒米呢？这个是0到20。 So this from 0 to 20. So it's like a clock, right?
I get it. This is the second hand, and this is the hour hand.
Yes.
And these are. Is this north?
Yeah,
这个表示的方向.
So north, south, east, and west.
红的朝南.
The red towards
朝南.
South.
Towards the south. Okay, so yeah. So it shows a direction.
南北东西.
That's pretty interesting.
东北.
Yeah.
西南西北.
So
eight direction, right? Northeast, northwest. 现在我们观测的仪器，电气风仪观测仪器是，有16方向了。三，您也说过的，那32方向是？不，16方向，16方向啊，是吧？So now
we have like the 16 wind direction. 16 wind direction. 西南偏北风都可以测了，这个只能最多测到东北。
西南这个八个方向。But
here only have eight.
Look, they've got your anemometers from yesteryear. Why didn't you take one of these outside?
No,
这个就是原来的，这个是一个外面的一个手持电气风仪。你要冲着镜头给我们大家展示一下。这是手持的电气风仪，手持的一个简便式电气风仪，是用于野外观测的。
是吧？随身可以带。Also for outdoors, like the one we just used, right?
Exactly. Only that's newer and electronic. This is just
这些都是叫我们叫封杯式的，都是因为后面都放都封杯式。这个呢是一个电极封仪，电极封仪呢后面呢现在我们其实在用的都是这种类似于这种电极封仪。那这个的话是一个封杯式，像一个杯子一样的，所以我们叫这个叫封杯。So
which was the
wind cup?
Which is the oldest unit out of all of these units?
Which is the oldest unit out of all of these units? 双压摆是封仪了，其实是来讲了，大家看到它是纯粹的这种好自然那种刻度式的。其实我们气象就是原来就是延伸于这个天文类学科的。其实来讲呢，我们有在看从这里可以多少看得出气象仪器跟天文仪器的有些还是一脉传承的。就是这个会更精确。这个是很好玩的，这个包现在我们电极封仪，在那个是我们现在那个八九十年代都还在用。 对吧？都这个，这个呢，是因为是19世纪，相对来讲，这两个用的比较早。这个上世纪的那个是70年代后，基本上这个都不用了。啊，这些都不用。这个上世纪50-60年代普遍还在用，后面就不行。So
what's still used in 1950s and 1960s?
This one here?
Yeah.
Okay.
And what about
这个的话是现在还在用？
这种现在就电极封仪，但是我们现在不是电极封仪，现在因为都是智能化的，是吧？这个就是这个都是无线传输的。这个在电极封仪的话，其实现在我们所有的看到的车封仪，不管是那种微型的或者是特殊的，都是封杯式的。这个我们看到气象标志两个，一个是封杯，风塔封杯，还有一个就是百叶箱，这个是气象站的标配。
So the wind cups here, this is what he called this, like cups. So we still use this cup today, but as more automated and more intelligent. And
electronic.
Yeah,
like we saw outside, all of this equipment has been changed into actually electronic computerized stuff that they can share the data all over the world because meteorology has no borders.
Yeah. Yes, of course. And here is even a bird. So, 这样，这个我们还看到一只鸟，叫象峰铜鸟。这个呢是一个象峰铜屋。我们中国是这个现存的最早的车封下的仪器，就是一个象峰铜屋。So,
Mr. Zhao said this is the earliest, like the anemometer for to detect the wind speed and the direction. So, 可以测到风向，对吧？风向。
它的那个，它的鸟嘴指的方向就是风的，它那边风的来向，什么风
？The bird's mouth, the direction it points to is where the wind comes.
这是我们一个模型，因为这个真迹的话，也是那个，是replica，not the
authentic one. 那您再带我们走一走吧，在这边啊。好的。我们看到还有好多的这种，用来测试的哈。
我们哇，这些很古老。防台抗台了，一个呢是防台，防是什么防？就是监测、预报、预警、服务。抗台的话就是在那个是我们是那个防御台风、抗击台风对我们生活甚至带来的危害。
So Kirk, when we talk about typhoon, it's very important about monitoring typhoon and warn about typhoon, right? Like the monitoring and warning system.
Well, you've got to know when they're coming because you've got people working on fish farms off the coast, the windmill farms off the coast. They've got oil rigs off the coast.
So these people have to know what's coming down the tube and have to be evacuated in time, like we saw at the hotel.
Yeah, and also I think that when we can monitor a typhoon, we can give a better warning, it's come more accurate. So tell people how to prepare and how they can cope with that.
Sandbagging for one,
yeah, of course.
You know, keeping the floods out.
Yeah, so in front of us are some of the very old times, the equipment people used to cope with typhoon. So Zhejiang, 跟我们讲讲。
台风对那个我们海岛地区、沿海地区来讲，它造成主要是三大危害：一个风的影响，一个是雨的影响，还有个潮位，就是
So Mr. Zhao says there are three, like the impacts mainly brought by typhoons: the wind, the tides, and also the rain.
台风危害的最直接表现就是海水倒灌、海堤决口、海淘溃塌、房屋倒塌。所以我们防台抗台主要还是什么？就是土木作业。 就是什么修海棠、借水利，用的什么呢？因为这些都是上世纪五六十年代，我们的海岛地区、沿海地区的劳动人民啊，他们自己这个建设台风抢修的时候用的。像这个呢，就是这是一套模型，做簸箕的，就是单土的，挑担的。
So they use this to
麻袋呢是装那个泥土。 来决口的，是海棠的决口。
So this back here actually is used to remove the mud and trying to fill where the seawater comes.
当时的话没有，外面也没有手电什么，也只能用那种煤油灯啊、汽油灯。那我们看到像这边也有一些这些比较稍微原始一点的这些器具啊。So
there are also some equipment used to cope with the typhoon.
对，劳动人民呢在那个。
这个流泥板是干嘛用的？
流泥板的话是什么呢？就是因为当时的我们的海棠大部分都是海棠水库堤坝，都是那个土石结构。泥块的话，怎么它比如这一块一块泥块切也不好切，就用什么呢？用那个切泥工把那个泥块切成一个豆腐格子一样一个小方块，方块切下来后呢，通过流泥板呢把它划下来，这样就是最简单的一个传输带。
Maybe it's for cutting mud.
Yes. Yeah, because when the mud, they are like piling up there. So they have, yeah, so people have to use this to cut the mud and they use this panel actually to deliver all the mud so they can slide, then make it easier to transfer and deliver them to other places so they can make sure it's smooth.
这些设备呢，它这些工具，这个小铁锤常见的水平啊什么，这些工具其实来讲就源自于它的生产实际的需求。嗯。Okay.
What's
那就是说这个实际的需求，就是说也是在防台抗台的时候。对，防台抗台那个兴修水利、建设海棠、台风抢险救灾的时候都用到。当时的话，因为生产条件有限，对，它只能是以手工作业。
When we cope with typhoon, it's still always important to build a dam or all the like facilities to prevent the typhoon and to better prepare. So those are all the tools when people use to construct a dam and other facilities.
Okay, but what's out, what's this one for? This particular one?
This
it looks like a cup on the long of a.
这个对，煮水瓢是做什么的？这个对，煮水瓢的话，不是那边在建水利的建海棠，它那个时候现在有钢筋水泥混凝土，钢筋结构，当时的就土，就是泥土啊，有时候泥土。
的话，它有搅拌的，用水搅拌的，它有这个，这个是一个模型，因为真正的要。
So
they have to use this to mix all the mud and the water to make the material for the construction.
Oh, okay. So they're actually building seawalls.
Yeah, and also dams like
dams to keep the water from going into the agricultural land or into the towns, villages, whatever.
I think you know a lot about this.
这些呢是一些，就是我们在冲这边来讲，我们能看得到。这些呢是一些我们那个是在上世纪啊，在防台抗台时候用过的一些器具，比如说信息通讯的照相机，就灾情调查。
My grandmother used to have a camera exactly like this. I don't think it was made in China, but I remember playing with it and then. And then taking a shot.
Yeah, it's like the good old, bringing us to the good old days.
You know, this is when I was a child. And see, most of this stuff that you're seeing right here, I have used.
These are the equipment and devices mainly for the information about typhoon and information to warn about the disasters before it comes. For example, the camera could. 这个照相机也是用来照照片的。灾情调查，对，台风天不是有受灾嘛？
调查高要灾情，这时候是在灾情之后了，对吧？这基本灾情之后，灾情之后。
So the camera is used after the typhoon to make investigation into the impacts and how we can prepare better for the next time.
这个叫气象警报接收器。
Can you see that weather warning receiver? If you can read
the weather warning receiver.
I thought
it was a radio.
Yeah, me too.
这是我们上世纪八九十年代，我们舟山市气象部门啊，就是自己这个我们安装在下面的渔船上面，下面的农村的田头上面的，他们可以便于无线接收我们及时发布的。 台风警报信号.
So what's it used in?
Where would these be put? Would people in their home?
这个是会放在大家家里吗？还是会就是在气象局啊？
这个是放在那个服务对象的那个服务点位上面，比如说船上、渔船上面，还有那个我们那个农村的村舍上面，是吧？农村合作社什么这个，这可以在第一时间通过无线接收我们的气象预报。So
this weather warning receiver is actually put in on fishing boats or like the country, like people in countryside for them to receive the weather warning.
Like the mayor of the village or whatever would have it.
So it's not a radio. It's a lot more professional actually.
Okay.
Yeah. 那这儿让我们看到后面讲了很多关于台风防御的。那么就是中国的这个沿海地区，尤其是东部沿海地区，其实非常的频繁。那么为什么我们能够有这么一个完备的系统，然后来这个预防台风？能给我们讲？So I was asking. So for East China's coastal areas, typhoon and other disasters have been very frequent, but they still have like we are seeing very comprehensive system of monitoring and warning system when they cope with typhoons. So I was asking him why.
Well, because I've only been here once.
You've already had the answer.
And I was here for a typhoon, so they must have them frequently here. I think they have, what, 13
very
a year?
Very experienced, yeah.
On an More average, 13 that, yeah. a year?
台风呢? 是这个，因为是对那个我们沿海地区，包括东南亚的沿海啊，等于是全球来讲，台风是一个很严重的一个气象的这个灾害系统。So
for globally, for internet, all the other countries, a typhoon has been very major disasters and has huge impact on people's life.
世界气象组织的各个成员国呢，一直来呢很重视对台风的研究。
那么我记得您说过，就是说我们其实是有一个共享数据，然后互相的这种，能多给我们讲一讲吗？气象无国界。
我们全球的在世界气象组织的领导下呢，我们全球各层气象组织成员国啊，一直长期来一直对于台风等气象这个学科的这个研究和台风预报气象预报的那个探索。
So Mr. Zhao says that when it comes to disasters and all this weather things, there's no board, right?
Well, there is no borders. And one of the questions I'd like to ask, he's been around this for a long time. So have the typhoons gotten worse over the last couple of years because of the global warming? Or
That's a good question.
Well, the idea that this was one of the fastest of five growing typhoons in history, from being a tropical depression to a super typhoon when it was hitting the Philippines. So do you see them getting bigger, harder, faster?
那赵长，柯很好奇啊，就是随着全球变暖，在近些年里面，这个台风有没有或者说极端天气，尤其是像台风有没有加剧，能给我们讲讲吗？随着那个全球的气候变暖啊，现在的话呢，就是对。
我们的这个气候的变化啊，有一些比较也很明显的，在各种极端天气更加加剧，比如说台风，啊，I would
imagine
so，还有一个就是那个极端的强降水，哦，like
typhoon and very strong torrential
rain，所以这个越来越这个，另外的话，现在这个是其实来讲呢，就是台风它是一个自然的一个气象的一个。 一个东西，但是的话呢，如果在那个我们那个在全球气候变暖这个大背景下，所以其实来讲呢，这个也出现了有些在我们的监测。
FISA has brought new challenges when it comes to a monitor and also worrying about the typhoon.
我们中国呢地大物博，我们中国的话呢，地域广泛，我们的那个气象在的对台风的监测，我们向世界贡献了我们中国力量。为什么？中国的气台监测从空气、风云系列卫星，到我们的海基，我们这个海上的浮标自动站啊，这种，还有到我们的陆基，我们。 全遍布全国的各地的那个自动观测站，我们是世界这个量是最大的。所以在台风预报跟研究跟这个中呢，我们首先我们中国贡献了我们的台风监测的这个的是。
So Mr. Zhang pointed something very important, also very interesting, because China has a vast land, and then so we have like devoted a huge efforts into the monitoring and also a warning of typhoon, and we share the data with all the other countries across the world, and then and we also because we have like satellites on in the sky. And also on sea, but also from land. So like three dimensions. We have like abundant data about typhoon, and then so we can monitor better. After that, we share this with all the other countries.
Okay, and the other countries share with you, I assume too, right?
Yeah, 所以我们想就是说，那我们跟国外的这个合作是什么样？那他们是不是也给我们提供了一些，比如说其他方面的，除了数据以外的？我们呢，向世界共享我们那个台风的监测这个数据。我们呢，同时呢也。
共享了，他们比如说欧洲中心的，或者是其他的一些世界各国的先进的数字预报经验，台风的预报经验，预报的那个他们的好的那个这个，所以的话就是通过我们的共享全球共享，通过我知道这一次就是说像欧洲中心，我们也会借助他们的一些技术上，这个能给我们数字预报，欧洲西方国家相对来讲，他们因为有些比我们先进，比我们这个。So
a lot of like European countries. And they have like more advanced technology when it comes to forecasting the typhoon. So we also like share together and cooperate to better know more about the disasters and how we can get prepared for that.
Yeah, and prepare for it. Like I noticed that they've got a seawall up here. We were here. Yeah. We were here yesterday.
Are you talking about this one?
No, outside the seawall.
Oh yes.
We were here yesterday and. The waves were crashing against that. If that wasn't there, the whole area on the other side of that seawall would be flooded out.
Yeah,
so
of
you
course.
See the infrastructure that they've got here, and I would imagine that's part of
part of 四条台风的主要路径。
So it shows four typical routes of typhoon that impacts China most.
Well, these are the
main. Can't tell. It's where you come from. It's Guangxi province. Yeah. It's Guangxi and.
We do get it every once in a while.
Yeah, I know. And it's Fujian province, Zhejiang province, Guangdong province.
So this one is a different one because it came from the Philippines up over Taiwan and then across along the coast.
灿都来讲，灿都属于这四个里面。这样，这里我们可以找到最近的两个台风，一个是十三号台风，
十三号台风现在是往哪？ 南海那边走的，南海那边，刚刚过去的，还有一个就是我们灿都台风，是最上面那条路径，现在最上面的路径。And
Chanthu is actually the
top one.
Yeah, the top one.
Only it was down a little, maybe a longer.
那它是不是还是低了一点呢？所以我们刚才在说的这次台风灿都台风的各大台预报上面路径上面还是有些偏差，怎么回事呢？ 它上去先是以地上面一条是在紧靠浙江或者上海，北上的，但是它上来的时候，它是从台湾的鄂伦边那边上去的，也是巴士海峡上去的，没有穿过台湾，就等于没有穿过台湾，对，所以它这个四条典型路径里面，它又有它的。 这个台风的有它的典型之处。So
Chanthu is quite similar to the up one, the most top one, but still very different to as it has north, because it's supposed to like go across Taiwan, and then it might be blocked by the mountains there. But instead of that, it goes quite like a, how would say like it avoids that. So it's very strong.
And up the coast and then on towards Japan.
现在是在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊，也在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊，也在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊，也在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊，也在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊，也在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊，也在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊，也在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊，也在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊，也在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊，也在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊，也在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊，也在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊，也在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊，也在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊，也在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊，也在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊，也在日本去了吗？没有，现在还在徘徊 湾，然后鼻子上去到了我们现在这个在那个浙江的沿海，
嗯，
然后直奔上海，目前现在在上海那个外以东的洋面上面在回旋扫动。
So Mr. Zhao says it passes Taiwan and heads north to Zhejiang, like what we experienced
yesterday.
Yeah. And now it lingers somewhere like the sea outside Shanghai, so it's quite stays there, and it probably bring more torrential rain.
So if it's sitting over ocean right now or sea, is it getting stronger or is it getting weaker?
它如果徘徊的话，是不是会更强一些，带来这个影响？
徘徊的话，因为它通过那个台风，其实从那个在中国那个沿海从南到北了，它那个长途跋涉，
嗯，
它其实来讲，它的能量已经有所消耗，现在在缓慢减弱中，从原来最强的中心风力十七级到现在的14级，
但它如果徘徊了，就目前它如果现在在上海外海徘徊的话，会不会越来越在聚集？
不会聚集的，但是在徘徊就什么？对我们的上海，
嗯，
对我们的浙江。带来还是持续不断的有那个大风，还有那个暴雨的影响。
So Mr. Zhao says because it has moved such a long distance, so it has the power has weakened a little bit.
Okay.
But now it has been lingering near the sea, so it will still have like huge torrential rain and bring strong gales for Shanghai.
Just like here still. You know, and it's been just about 24 hours and we're still in it.
And I know, Kirk, I know you've been in Navy before, so I wonder, have you ever encountered
a
hurricane when you were in Navy, and how is it like?
Well, you know, everybody, I'm old. I'm as old as volcanic ash. Back in 1977, I was in the Canadian Navy, and we're in the central North Pacific area going through a hurricane. I was young then, you know, 10-foot tall and bulletproof. So I wasn't afraid. Now I'd be afraid. The idea that I was on a destroyer escort, the HMCS Saskatchewan, actually, and it was loud. And we'd go up a wave, and because you batten down all the hatches, so you're sort of like a cork. And we'd come off the top of a wave, and it's just loud, and we'd come down, and then all of a sudden it would be just quiet, because we were actually under the water. This whole destroyer escort was under the water. And then it'd be quiet, then all of a sudden you pop to the surface, and it just... again. And so like, yeah, I've seen it up close and personal. And the force, like in these swells and waves were, I would imagine, 100 feet high. It was scary.
Yes, super scary.
Well, I think the captain of the ship was actually worried about what was going on. Me, I was just, you know what I mean?
Yeah, because you were super young and dumb.
Hey?
Yeah. 那局长，那个就是说，我们也很想知道，就是对于我们个人来说，怎么更好的这个做为台风做准备，然后减少这个损失。
台风的话呢，因为它对带来的主要的灾害呢，无非就是风雨潮。
嗯。
我们最怕的也是风雨潮塞碰头。
嗯。
所以在台风来临之前呢，我们呢作为我们的市民呢，第一首先要及时收听，及时的获取。我们当地权威的气象部门的这个台风的预报，台风的预警信号。
I was asking, so for us, how should we better prepared and for a typhoon? And Mr. Zhao suggested that we should always listen to the warning, like the warning receiver, and know about its latest situation.
And do what they tell you on.
Yeah, just follow the instructions.
Follow the instructions.
Stay at home and. And
that's what we were told, to, you know, to stay in the hotel, don't go outside.
Yeah.
It may not look dangerous, but those high winds can maybe blow a piece of tin off the top of a roof, and, you know, things happen. So
to
avoid
dangerous.
Accidents,
so I have to
stay
home
inside.
And then follow all the instructions.
然后的话呢，要及时的做好在台风来临之前做好必要的那些准备工作、防御措施。比如说，要在家里的话呢，要准备。一定量的，那个是食品， 一定要的那个饮用水什么，以防停电停水，要准备好那个应急的照明的小水手电筒等啊。
Mr. Zhang also suggests that we should prepare enough food and water to make sure that we have things to eat and drink at home.
I knew that because as soon as this was going to hit, I said, let's go to the store and get supplies.
Yeah. So what did you get?
I got beer.
That's really.
I got beer and peanuts and some ichiban soups and some cookies and just some fruit.
That will make you make sure that you will have like good time still during the typhoon season.
Well, that's just it. I could have got water, but we could always boil water at the at the hotel, so I figured the beer was more important.
Yeah.
门窗呀，还有比如阳台上面易被风吹落坠落的一些物件，要检查好，加固好。再是另外一个呢，要在台风影响的时候，避免外出。为什么外面风雨影响啊？要防触电、漏电的影响，是吧？要防那个火灾的影响。
So Mr. Zhao also suggested that we have to fix our doors and windows and trying to, especially those parts that easily falling down, which could be very dangerous. And also stay home and then try to avoid outdoors activities.
Exactly.
So we're going to wrap our live streaming here today. And thank you so much. 谢谢您，赵局长。哎，谢谢您，我们今天就结束了啊！非常谢谢您参与到我们直播。Thank you so much. And that's all from us.
See you later.
Bye. Stay tuned. Bye.